This is the Flutter Bloc overview section. This section covers the essentials you need to know when developing an app using Flutter Bloc as a state management solution. First, let's take a quick look at what a bloc is. Bloc is an abbreviation of business logic component and can be considered as the brain of the app. Let's look at the structure of a typical app. The app consists of a presentation layer where users can see and interact, and a business logic layer that receives the user request, for example, show me the latest stock price, then makes a request to the data layer, process the data received from the data layer, and delivers them to the presentation layer. Here, the request is called an event, and the data is called a state. So, a bloc can be seen as a machine that receives the events as the input and outputs the state as the output. So, we need two communication channels between bloc and UI. In other words, there should be a channel that sends events from UI to bloc and a channel that sends the state that is a result of event processing from bloc to UI. If you think about the life cycle of an app, a series of events, such as a user clicking a button or fetching data from a remote API, occurs while the app is running. You never know in advance when an event will occur or how often it will occur. The site that handles the event just listens to see if the event occurs, and when the event occurs, it processes and sends a result. However, the UI cannot know when a new state will come as a result of processing the requested event. Just listen to the processing result of bloc and update the UI when the result comes. These events and state occur asynchronously throughout the life cycle of your app. However, Dot provides a stream that can handle a series of continuous asynchronous data. It is a very good tool for passing events and state between UI and bloc. For this reason, the Flutter Bloc package uses a stream as a communication channel between the UI and bloc. Let's take a look at what a Dart stream is for a moment. In Dart, streams are created using the async generator function. I just said that a stream is a sequence of asynchronous data sets, right? Therefore, to create a stream, you need a tool that can create a function that generates data asynchronously. To create an async generator function, use the async star keyword. The async star keyword allows you to use the yield keyword within a function. Yield I on count stream pushes integer I into stream. That is, count stream pushes data to the stream every 1 second while looking the for loop as much as max given as an argument. From the side of the stream user, you must first create the stream you want to use. We created a count stream called myCountStream by giving 5 as an argument to countStream. However, as mentioned before, from the perspective of using the stream, it is not possible to know when data will come, so you have to listen to whether data is coming or not. Stream provides a function called listen for this. The listen function receives the void type callback as an argument. This void type callback is executed whenever new data is read from the stream. Now that we have a quick look at what a stream looks like in Dart, let's look at some of the features that bloc should have. First, it reads the event that occurred in the UI, analyzes the event, and requests the appropriate event handler to handle it. The event handler processes the event through the interaction with the various data sources, and the bloc reflects the new data resulting from the event processing the UI. In other words, to use a bloc, we need to define events and implement the event handlers. However, in the case of a simple app, defining events in advance and implementing event handlers does not have much merit and increases the amount of code that needs to be created. Also, defining events like this and implementing event handlers is a task that beginners find difficult. And regardless of the author's intention, developers were using it in a way that defines a function in bloc and adds a new state within the function. So, qubit, a method of defining public function that can be called from outside and emitting a new state directly from that function, was officially adopted in the Flutter Bloc package. In other words, qubit is a slimmed down version of bloc. In summary, qubit calls the public method provided by the qubit directly from the UI to request event processing, and reads the new state, which is a process resolved through the stream. On the other end, block reads an event from the stream setup between the block and UI, processes the event inside the block, and then sends a state to the UI using the stream again. Let's take a closer look at Qubit. Qubit is a class that can be extended to manage any type of state. To use it in an app, define the state and create a qubit, then manage the state. We'll call it MyQubit here. When creating MyQubit, the type of state to be managed must be specified. MyQubit, which extends Qubit, provides a public function that can be called from the UI. When a function is called from the UI, a new state value is created in func1, a public function, and the value of the current state can be accessed through the state variable provided by Qubit. Next, the new state value is dispatched to the stream using the emit function provided by Qubit. If you need an additional value to create a new state, you can pass it as an argument to func1. To reorganize the process, first of all, define the state to be handled in MyQubit. Next, we specify the initial state. If you need to provide an initial state value from the outside, you can pass any state through the constructor as shown in the picture on the left. Next, in func1, a new state is calculated, and the current state value can be accessed through the state variable provided by Qubit. When the new state is calculated, the new state is dispatched to the state stream using the emit function provided by Qubit. Note that emit is a protected function. In other words, you cannot call the emit function outside the subclass of Qubit. Let's take a closer look at Bloc this time. Bloc is a class that can be extended to manage any type of state. To use in the app, define state and event and create a block, then manage the state. We'll call it MyBlock here. When creating MyBlock, you must specify the event type that causes state change and the type of state it manages. MyBlock, which extends block, receives the event dispatched to the event stream by using the add function provided by block in the UI. And MyBlock calls the onEventHandler corresponding to the event type. The onEventHandler creates a new state value, and the current state value can be accessed through the state variable provided by block. Next, the new state value is dispatched to the stream using the emit function provided by block. In the case of Bloc, if an additional value is needed to create a new state, it is transmitted as a payload of the event. To rearrange the process, first of all, define the event and state to be handled in MyBlock. Next, we specify the initial state. If you need to provide an initial state value from the outside, you can pass any state through the constructor as shown in the picture on the left. Next, register an event handler using the onEvent API. Inside the event handler, a new state is computed, and the current state value can be accessed through the state variable provided by the block. When the new state is calculated, the new state is dispatched to the state stream using the emit function provided by block. One thing to note here is that emit should only be called within an event handler. To summarize, to make a qubit, define the state and implement a function to handle the state. To create a block, we define a state and event and implement an event handler to handle the event and state. Note that both block and qubit ignore consecutive overlapping states. If the current state is equal to the next state, then no state change occurs. However, there are cases where a different state is needed to create a new state. In this case, how can you know the value of another state? Both the qubits and blocks dispatch a new state to the state stream. In the UI, it listens to the stream and takes action such as rebuilding the UI. Qubit and block have a getter called stream for the state stream. Therefore, qubit and block can listen to the necessary state stream. If you want to read the state value of another qubit or block from a specific qubit or block, you can listen to the stream getter or MyQubit or MyBlock instance is shown on the right. Then the callback register to listen is executed every time a new state value is dispatched to the stream. And for qubit or block to have meaning, it needs to communicate with the UI. What do you need in the UI to communicate with Qubit or Bloc? First, you need to create an instance of Qubit or Bloc and inject it into the widget tree so that the instance can be easily used in widgets. It is a widget called Bloc Provider that does the work. Next, Qubit or Bloc must provide the ability for the app to raise events. To do that, your app needs to have the ability to find the qubit or bloc it needs. Over static method and read extension method in the box provide such a function. If you find a qubit or bloc, you should be able to trigger an event. Qubit provides a public method, and bloc provides the ability to add events to a stream. Here too, public function or add methods can be accessed through over static method or a read extension method. The triggered event creates a new state, so the app needs to read the new state created by qubit or bloc and take the necessary action. To do that, your app needs to have the ability to find the qubit or bloc it needs. Bloc providers over static method, watch extension method, bloc builder, bloc listener, bloc consumer widget, etc. perform this function. Once you find a qubit or bloc, you should be able to read the state from the state stream and decide what action to take. For example, after reading the state, you need to decide whether to reveal the UI, display a dialog, or reveal the UI and display a dialog as well. For each case, the Flutter Bloc package provides a variety of tools. The widgets or methods displayed in the box will be explained while dealing with examples. So there is no problem if you do not know them well now. Now that we have looked at the theory, let's see how that theory can be implemented in an app. Let's start with a simple app.